Hello champions, today we are playing on the European theater map and I'm the third player in this game. First of all, let's take a look at the regional bonuses. As you can see, each region over here gives +4 troops. Let's see where we've got most of our territory spawn, and it must be Africa. Even 3 territories right here, guys. Let's see what our objective is to conquer Western Europe, conquer Africa and conquer 4 territories from Asia, so going for Africa really works in this case. You win by either completing your objective, or in case nobody completes their objective after round 10 ends, then the player who has most territories after round 10 wins, and in case there's a tie, there will be one more additional round. So without any further ado, let's think in those territories over here, guys. Let's go. I'm adding more troops next to the blue player because the blue player got more territories over here, guys, so it would be more likely, but he could decide to go for the same exact continents. Let's attack to Morocco, let's attack to Algeria as well, and finally attack to Egypt. In this game, you're limited to only making 3 attacks, and also beforehand you do not see where other players are adding their troops to. Right here, the cyan player decides to go for Western Europe, guys, and the orange player decides to go for Central Europe. They will be big enemies if each other, and right here, see what the blue player adds his troops to Northern Eurasia and Asia as well. The orange and cyan players waste their troops on each other, good for us. The cyan player right here will be in a very bad situation because the blue player will take down his territories next to himself as well. Good for us, bad for the cyan player. Round 2 receive +8 troops, guys. If you want to find out how many troops you receive, you need to divide your territories number by 2 and round up. So in this case I had 9 territories. If we divide by 2, we get 4.5, and since we round up, I only receive 4 troops. Then you also get troops for your regional bonuses, in which case I have Africa for +4 troops as well. Then every turn you get at least an energy, and then for every attack you receive +5 more energy as well. So the most you can receive in a single turn is 2500. Here, this is the number I received, guys. Let's add more troops over here. Let's add more troops over here, guys, and maybe let's attack a territory over here in Britain, why not? Let's attack Spain, and I think maybe it will be it, guys, because I assume the blue player will expand into those territories. Might have been smart for me to add more troops, guys, on this border and try breaking through the blue player over here in Asia, but oh well. The orange player uses reinforcements to strengthen his army. The blue player uses the sniper option to prevent me going for Asia, smart by him, but in this case, I didn't even add any troops, and wasn't going to go in Asia anyway, but a smart play by the blue player for sure. He captures Asia, he will be receiving +4 troops. Round 3, and I receive 8 troops again, guys. 4 troops by having 9 territories, and 4 troops by having Africa. This turn I receive +20 energy instead of 25, because I only made 2 attacks instead of 3. Let's remember our objective, guys. Okay, is to conquer Western Europe and conquer 4 territories from Asia, besides conquering Africa. So what will I do, guys, is I will add more troops over here, because I think your blue player will look forward to break for us. Let's strengthen this border by a little bit as well. Let's add troops over here as well. I will use reinforcement option in order to strengthen my African border right here by a lot. Let's make attack France, and let's send some troops over here as well, guys. Unfortunately, I run out of time, but it might be even better, guys, because I'm not sure how much a blue player will strengthen his troops, his borders. So in case he strengthened his troops, his borders by a lot, so I could end up just wasting those troops. Hopefully that isn't the case. The orange player right here loses a bunch of troops, so blue player uses the card which gives defenders for him, for he used the defenders on the top set of his territory, so good for me. Right here I strengthen that army over here, and the blue player ends up strengthening this army as well, guys. He used blockade to prevent me from taking the territory. Right here is the sniper option to basically eliminate me from the territory. The blue player just simply ends up wasting those troops, guys, because I strengthen my border by a lot. And the cyan player uses the paratroopers option in order to infiltrate in one of the orange player's territories. Round 10, I receive the same number of troops again, guys, +8 troops. This turn I only receive 15 energy, guys, I only made a single attack. But oh well, what I will do in this turn is I will add more troops over here. I'll add more troops over here as well, guys. And what I want to do is to use minefield over here. In case the blue player attacks the territory, guys, he will lose even 4 troops. And myself, let's attack into Italy, let's attack into Germany as well. And at the same time, I would like to take over Saudi Arabia as well, guys. Let's start from the bottom over here. I think that will be our play. Let's send 7 troops. And let's end our turn. This turn we will make all 3 attacks, guys. Rocky War production by Orange Player. It have Blue Player and substrengthening all of his borders basically besides that one with two troops. Right. Yeah, okay, he uses that comms. Hijack attack guys basically sends my troops way back, so lucky for the blue player. It have orange player uses the kamikaze attack on me, but also wastes troops on the cyan player, which is good for us. And right here, break through the blue player, good for us, guys. The blue player will receive getting plus 4 troops fewer. I receive 9 troops. What I will do is add more troops on this territory for sure. Let's strengthen those borders over here as well, guys. And let's add the rest of my troops over here, guys. What I will do is use chemical warfare, which will take down 50% of the blue player's troops in this territory. So let's do it. Let's also use block it. Or maybe no. Because right here I will attack first, guys. So if I take that army down, so I do not even have to use block it. Let's go over here. And also, should I use airstrike option, guys? Maybe not. Let's send our troops to Germany like that. From France and from Italy at the same time as well, guys. I will fortify those troops to Libya. Well, I'm only limited to making 3 attacks or actions a turn, so in this case I wasn't able to proceed doing that, but let's see whether our plan will still be successful over here. I block it used by the CN player over here, but the blue player uses the sniper option, guys, which kills one troop plus cancels attack on those territories. Unluckily for us, we weren't able to take over this territory. Right here, the blue player just simply wastes troops, guys, with his smaller army because we used the chemical warfare attack successfully. So we're still good in this situation, and looking at our objective, guys, we're getting closer and closer towards meeting our goal. We still need to capture those 2 more territories in Western Europe, plus we need 4 territories from Asia, or 3 more. So what will I do is I will strengthen this army over here, guys. I will also add more troops to this territory, and of course I will make sure to add more troops on this territory, guys. Let's use the reinforcements option. Let's send 6 troops to Israel, let's send 5 troops to Iraq, and right here let's attack to Britain, let's send 5 troops, let's go. 5 defensive troops for the blue player. As you can see, he's strengthening those armies over here. He wants to prevent me from taking over those territories. The orange player uses reinforcements attack. I mean, ability card over here. He wants to take down those troops of the cyan player, and he ends up taking over that successfully, guys. He ends up taking over Central Europe. Good for him right here. I still capture territories. Good for me, and the cyan player loses the game, guys, right? Yes, he has been eliminated from the game, and in this case, it's a little bit bad for me because this player were targeting orange and blue, and at the same time those 2 players end up taking over Central Europe and Northern Asia. We've got a continent each as well, but I'm very close towards meeting my goal, guys. I basically only need to take over Iceland and one more territory in Asia, guys, and I think I win the game. So this is what I'm going to do. And since it's my turn, guys, I think I win the game immediately after that, right? Yes, so let's just send my troops right like that, guys, and I think I'm winning the game, right? Let's take over Iceland over here. Let's attack to Turkey over here like that. Let's actually use airstrike attack, guys, over here, because a blue player might add a lot of troops, and let's attack to Iran as well, guys. And that's it. Let's see if we immediately win the game by completing or objective. Those players can still use special ability cards, which could prevent me from achieving my goal. So right here is the sniper option, guys, but it won't do much. Alright, we end up taking over Western Europe, guys, and do we win the game? Yes! That's a victory! That's a nice and sweet victory for us, guys.